Welcome to Union Lutheran Church. Please join us for worship this first Sunday of Lent. In the name of God, who created us, who holds us and the whole world in his hands. In the name of the Son, who came into the world, who reconciles us with God. And in the name of the Holy Spirit, who fills us with eternal life, who links us with all Christians and incites us to peace, we come together to offer our thanks and praise. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And let us pray. Compassionate God, how easily you love those who look unlovable to us. How readily you welcome undesirables into your home. How slow we are to follow your example. Turn our hearts toward all who are considered outcast, shunned, and unclean, so that we may love our neighbor without pity or apathy, for the sake of the one who became flesh to cleanse the world of sin and death forever, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen. In the book of Deuteronomy, today I have given you the choice between life and death, between blessings and curses. Oh, that you would choose life, that you and your descendants might live. God has set before us life and death. The choice is ours. Let us acknowledge our misuse of the liberty of choice. Let us search our hearts. And let us ask to be forgiven for the times when we have chosen poorly, opting for the way of easy way of habit and social convention rather than the ways of Jesus. And let us confess that sometimes our choices have been made from selfishness, with little concern for those around us, even for those who love us dearly. And let us ask to be forgiven for putting off decisions, for hesitating and avoiding choice until opportunity has gone by. And let us confess that we have at times made outwardly good decisions for the wrong reasons, driven by selfish motives. Holy God, Savior, we rest our mortal lives in your immortal life, allowing your grace, mercy, and peace to cleanse, refresh, and strengthen us. Now, as the Apostle Paul wrote, if you confess with your lips that Jesus Christ is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. These words contain the good news that in Jesus Christ we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Amen.
A Psalm of David. O Lord, who may abide in your tent? Who may dwell on your holy hill? Those who walk blamelessly and do what is right, and speak the truth from their heart, who do not slander with their tongue, and who do no evil to their friends, nor take up a reproach against their neighbors, in whose eyes the wicked are despised, but who honor those who fear the Lord, who stand with their oath even to their hurt, who do not lend money at interest, and do not take a bribe against the innocent. Those who do these things shall never be moved.
And the man was traveling down the road when he was jumped upon by robbers and beaten, stripped of everything, and thrown in the ditch, left for dead. But coming down that road, there was a priest, a man who served in the temple of the Lord. And when he spotted the man down there, he remembered all of the duties he had, and he was busy. So he looked the other way and passed by, leaving the man there. But also coming down that road was a Levite, a teacher of the law, God's law. And he too spied the man laying in the ditch and thought about, if I stop, what if they jump me? He pretended not to see and crossed over to the other side. But coming down the road was a Samaritan, foreigner, someone who didn't worship God the way we did. And when he saw the man laying there, he had compassion, and he went over immediately. He bound up his wounds and cleaned them and dressed them, and put him up on his own animal and led him down till he found an inn. He carried him in, put him in a bed, and gave the innkeeper money, and said, when I come back this way again, if there's any more bills to be paid, I will pay them. And Jesus looked at the young man, who had asked him, who is my neighbor? And Jesus turned to him and said, which of these three was neighbor? And he replied, the one who showed mercy. Then go and do likewise. The Gospel of the Lord. I was just back here at the looking at the map here of the world. So, like, found us here on the map. You might be able to see we're kind of here between the Statue of Liberty and the cow. Kind of appropriate since we've got some cows in our neighborhood. Neighborhood. In fact, isn't that what Jesus was kind of talking about? In fact, talking about who our neighbor is. And he gives us this very strange story about a man who got beat up and was left all injured. And three people came along. And the first two didn't help. The third one, though, stopped and helped. And realizing that Jesus wants us to think about who our neighbor is. And not just somebody like really, really tiny place like this, but people from all over. Because everybody is God's children. And God wants us to see everybody as a neighbor and somebody that we should care about. So when you look and you see somebody new in your life, remember that they're God's children as well. And even if they don't look like you, if they don't talk like you, they're still loved by God, just the way God loves you. And God wants you to share that love with everybody. Will you join me in a word of prayer? Dear God, we thank you that you have made so many different and interesting people in our lives. Help us to remember that you love them like you love us, and help us to treat them with that same love. In Jesus' name, amen. One day, an old rabbi was walking through his town where his synagogue was located, passing by a building that happened to make soap. Remembering that the owner of the company was a member of his synagogue, he was wondering, he hadn't seen him in a long time, perhaps he might be in. As he was heading towards the entrance, the owner happened to be coming out, heading out to lunch. The rabbi approached him and said, it's been a long time since we've seen you at service. Said, you should come and pray and sing with us. The owner of the soap company looked at him and said, now, Rabbi, he said, I'm a very busy man. I do a lot of good in the community. He said, I don't really think I have time for wasting coming to the synagogue. Besides, he said, Take a look around the world. What good does faith and religion actually do? You still see violence and hatred and anger. Wars still happen. Homeless and hungry. What good does faith and religion do? They continued walking. The rabbi didn't respond to this. They walked in silence for a ways. They came across a young boy who had found a mud puddle, was splashing about, having a grand old time. He had made an old-fashioned little paper boat and was floating it around, chasing it. He was covered head to toe in mud and soaking wet. And they stopped, and the rabbis pointed to the little boy and said, "Look at him. He's covered head to toe in mud. There's soap and all kinds of cleaning products all over the world, isn't there? Why, your factory cranks out soap every day. What good does it do? Look at him." The gentleman who owned the soap company looked at the rabbi and said, "But you don't understand. It won't do any good unless you actually use the soap and clean him." And the rabbi looked at him and said, "And the same thing applies to faith and your religion. If you don't use it, nothing's going to happen." Jesus tells us the very famous parable of the Good Samaritan. The other two, the priest and the Levite, had faith and religion. They were keepers of faith, and they were keepers of religion. But the point Jesus is making is, just because you have it, if you don't use it, nothing ever changes. Anybody can sit there on Facebook and put up some kind of "I love Jesus" post and say, "I bet I don't get 1,000 likes for this." But does it do anything? Jesus wants to have us to have more than just simply have faith, but wants us to pick up the bar of soap and scrub every so often. Roll up our sleeves and not just simply say, "Well, we'll pray for the hungry and the homeless." Let's do something with this faith, with our religion. Almost every Sunday, there's a group of people who come up and check the little food pantry, make sure it's restocked. Daily, we have people who stop in to make sure that the hungry have food. People bring and drop off and donate. They've rolled up their sleeves and said, "You know, the next time I'm in the store, I'm going to make sure I get, not for me, but for those in need." And bring and share. Our Super Bowl of caring, we almost 400 cans of soup came in. Loud Offering had over $390 that came crashing in, in spite of bad weather. Because a lot of good people of faith roll up their sleeves and grab that bar of soap and say, "What good does it do if it just simply sits there on the sink? Nothing will ever get cleaned. No one will ever get helped. No lives will be touched." The Levite and the priest had faith. They just didn't want to use it. They left it on the shelf, there on the sink, on that little indentation that holds the bar of soap. Didn't want it to get dirty or wet or anything like that. It was the Samaritan who was willing to take time and to use gifts and talents that he had in the simplest and humblest of way to care for somebody else, to put somebody else's needs ahead of theirs for that moment. Let us give thanks that God has given us faith, and let us give thanks that God has given us the strength to pick up the bar of soap when we go into the dirty world and to bring that faith with us and to do something with it. Amen.
For her groom.
The Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Beloved friends, in this season of repentance and healing, we accept God's invitation to be ever mindful of the needs of others, offering our prayers on behalf of God's community in the church and the world. Teach the church what it means to love and serve our neighbors. Keep us from hypocrisy and fear, that we may truly see and reach out towards all people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Teach humanity to care for the earth as you care for it. Help us to see the interconnectedness of the world and work to preserve what you have entrusted to us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Teach our leaders the ways of justice and peace, and grant us all the humility to set the welfare of all over our own personal desires. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Teach us to reach out in love and support to those around us, pursuing loving and edifying relationships and community. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Teach us how to best love and support those who are suffering in mind, body, or soul. And grant us the courage to care for them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Teach this assembly how to walk in your ways and how to best serve our communities and neighbors. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give you thanks for the teaching of the saints. We pray that we too may sound forth your praise and glory in our thoughts, words, and deeds. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Fill us with your strength to resist the seductions of our foolish desires and the tempter's vain delights, that we may walk in obedience and righteousness, rejoicing in you with an upright heart. Amen.
The Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Upon the cross forsaken.
And just a few announcements to share with you this morning. First, please keep Gary Wassum and Donald Weaver in your prayers. Both are home recovering from surgeries, but we continue to pray for them as the healing process continues. Also, a reminder that next Sunday, February 28th, is our annual meeting, be held in person following the outdoor worship service in the parking lot. Also coming up, April 1st, will be First Holy Communion. If you'd like to have your children part of that, please contact the church office to register them for First Holy Communion. And also a reminder that each Wednesday, check your inbox for the link to the Holden Evening Prayer Service, and also another of Chef Terry's Soups of the Week. The quiet strength of Christ, the humble power of God, the pervasive light of the Spirit is yours today and always. Go in peace, share the good news. Thanks be to God.